It's time to replace the battery in your car, but with all the different types, brands and sizes, where do you begin? In today's video, we'll talk about choosing the right battery for your vehicle. Let's get into it. The easiest approach to go about this is to identify which battery you currently have. So, you go ahead and open the bonnet and realize the battery is missing. No, it's still there. But the problem with most modern cars is that the battery is hidden under multiple covers, installed under the seats, or even in the boot. This is typical on sports cars where the engineers try to keep the center of gravity as low as possible or try to distribute the weight in the vehicle. So now what? Let's first talk about the normal cars, if you will, where the battery is visible in the engine bay. Now, if you notice a bunch of numbers on the battery sticker, you're in luck. The ones you're looking for is the amp hour rating together with a CCA or cold cranking amps rating. If the battery was manufactured in South Africa, you will see a three-digit number either on top or on the side of the battery that starts with a 6, like 618 or 658. This is the SABMA number or a code assigned by the South African Battery Manufacturers Association. The three-digit number is a standard that gives us information about the battery dimensions, the post orientation, the amp hour rating, and CCA rating. The last two might differ slightly between battery brands, but overall, if you have this number, you're pretty much ready to start shopping. But what if your battery doesn't have a sticker or any numbers on it? Keep watching. We'll get to this later in the video. Now that you have some technical specs on the battery, the next step is to determine the type of battery. There are basically two types of automotive lead acid batteries, flooded and AGM, which stands for absorbed glass matte. Which one do you choose? Well, the answer is quite simple. If your vehicle has a stop-start system, meaning the engine switches off automatically when the vehicle comes to a stop, and starts automatically when you release the brake or touch the accelerator, AGM is a must. AGMs offer a few benefits. They can be discharged deeper before needing a charge again. They recover quicker for the next stop-start cycle. Their performance in terms of cranking amps and amp hours are better than flooded batteries. They're not spillable because the electrolyte is contained in a glass mat structure. They last much longer, and they can be used in vehicles without stop-start systems. The disadvantages are they're only available in 6 different sizes. Due to the construction, they are much more expensive. The benefits definitely outweigh the disadvantages. So if you have a thick wallet and your battery is available in AGM, this is the right battery type for you. Alternatively, if your vehicle doesn't have a stop-start system, the next best option would be a flooded battery or EFB, enhanced flooded battery, for vehicles with lots of electronics, like infotainment systems or LCD displays and vehicle lighting systems, including homecoming lights or door and footwell lights. A question that pops up quite frequently is, will a bigger battery do damage? The short answer is no. A common analogy we use is fitting a bigger geyser in your house. The bigger geyser will still supply the same amount of water, but it will have more hot water available if needed. So it's more about what the battery can offer rather than the supply. The last step before you go and buy, and for those that don't have any information available on the currently fitted battery, is to use one of the many tools available on the internet to get a general idea of the recommended battery for your vehicle. Simply go to Google and type in battery finder tool. Most of them will require you to fill in the year, make, and model of your vehicle, and perhaps the model variant. You might get different results from different tools, and this is because there might be an overlap of two different models in the same year. But compare a few results on the required amp hours and cold cranking amps to determine a recommended battery for your vehicle. Also, consult your vehicle's owner manual for the battery size, or simply type your vehicle info into Google and scan through the images tab to determine the size. I hope you found this video helpful, so please like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one. Until next time.